I'm searching the web for the latest gaming news. Searching GameZillaMedia.com. Downloading headline.
Understand, what about this monster story of yours?
Download complete.
Yes, the news topic number one. We're going to kick it right over to Deadite because I don't even need to talk about it. But we got some games confirmed. Deadite, what do we got?
So we know that there are what looks to be confirmations that a full HD port of Barbie's Wild Horse Adventure is coming to PlayStation 4.
Yeah!
We're riding horses. We're taming stallions.
I am winning over Ken's heart. Wait, is that... No?
Yes, Ken is somebody in Barbie.
No, I know Ken is. I just thought you guys would all be excited about winning over
Ken. Thank you, JazzE, for the confirmation.
I just thought he was lost.
No, I didn't think I was lost at all. I just was a little concerned that you guys didn't jump on the Ken board.
He's a dreamboat. I'm not going to get in on your man.
Yeah.
I'm not going to do that.
Yeah.
No, there's leaks coming out. This is not the first time that this has happened, but the ratings board for Korea. It was someone in one of the Koreas.
The ESRB ratings.
There you go. I was right about that. Has leaked an early rating for Castlevania Symphony of the Night, The Goat, as well as Castlevania Rondo of Blood, and it's looking like they're going to be released as a two-pack of games.
Yeah, so this is really cool because, I guess out of all the Castlevania games, this is one that means a ton to me because it is kind of the birth of Metroidvania around the Castlevania series, where they really refined it and created such an amazing game it stands the test of time. It's one of those games that I don't care what system it's on. If I can get a hold of it, I'll play it.
These two games show the end of one era of Castlevania and the beginning of another era. Rondo of Blood was not released in an easy way to access because it was on the TurboGrafx-16. Right. And that was the last of the side-scrolling, level-by-level-based Castlevania. And then it directly fed into Symphony of the Night. Well, Symphony of the Night is where Castlevania became the Vania part of Metroidvania. It's one giant castle. There aren't individual levels. And you're going through, and they add the RPG elements of leveling up and getting different equipment and weapons. And you play as Alucard, the son of Dracula. And it's super cool because the intro scene of Symphony of the Night is the last scene of Rondo of Blood. They tie directly into each other. And not to be mistaken, Rondo of Blood isn't exactly the same game as Dracula X, which was released on the Super Nintendo. They're supposed to be sort of the same game, but there were differences in the port and the gameplay. And Dracula X just isn't considered to be nearly as good of a game as the version that is Rondo of Blood. So we are seeing the best version of that game and then Symphony of the Night. If you've never played Symphony of the Night, I'm going to be honest with you. I've played some, but I've never done a full playthrough. I have it on PlayStation 3. Here's the problem, and here's why I'm excited about this. I'm not going to sit down and play my PlayStation 3. Let's be honest. For maybe, 15 hours probably to get through Symphony of the Night, am I going to sit down and really go at it on my PlayStation 3? Not so much. Now, here's my concern. Even released on PlayStation 4, I'm wondering how much time I'm going to put into this because I want to buy it. But there's already the rumor mill is swirling around that this could make it to Switch as well.
Yes.
Ooh.
And that's where everything changes for me because I have firsthand experience that when you take a game I like and put it on PlayStation 4, I can kind of enjoy it. My example is Axiom Verge. I liked playing Axiom Verge on PlayStation 4, but I only made it a few hours in. But then when Grimm gave me a copy of Axiom Verge on the Switch, that's when I was able to actually put time in and complete it. Post up on the couch, throw something on TV, and just enjoy the handheld experience. On my lunch break, sitting to get my oil changed, those are the times that I can sit down and dig into a Metroidvania game a little bit more. It's just a game that it's important to not get lost and confused and lose the map. It's important to not take large breaks from it. And when it's a handheld game, you don't have to take large breaks from it. I love the Castlevanias on the Game Boy Advance because it's really easy for me to throw it in my pocket and just go. And when I have, 10 minutes to play, I hop in, explore the castle a little bit, save, and move on with my life. And if this game does make it to Switch, that's going to be a day one buy for me for sure.
Yeah, day one buy for me too.
Is either of these games, because you're the Castlevania guru and I'm
not
at all.
Guru is a little bit of a stretch. Enthusiast. We'll say enthusiast.
Either of these games in relation to what they have done with the Netflix series?
No. The Netflix series, if I remember correctly, retells Curse of Dracula, which is 3. Dracula's okay. Curse, I should say, which is Castlevania 3 on the NES. And I'm going through my mental Rolodex a little bit on those rumors. And one of the reasons people believe that this could hit Switch is, of course, because Simon and Richter are in Smash Brothers, and Richter is the star of Rondo of Blood. That I think that's what the feeling of it is sort of based on, and that makes a ton of sense. If you think about that, they're going to allow these characters to go into Super Smash Brothers, a system-selling marquee game on the Nintendo Switch. Why wouldn't they also take the ports of these games and put them on that system, unless there's still some sort of, especially with Symphony of the Night, old licensing that ties them to being PlayStation exclusive.
I mean, you're talking PS...
Symphony of the Night also may have been on Saturn. May have been. Don't crucify me if I made that up.
I don't know if it is.
I thought
the bottom line
it was.
Is, I think any
Tess, can you look that up?
Any deals that you have made back in the PS1 era, I think at this point would be done, but... I mean, unless you made some horrible deal.
You'd think so with the Final Fantasy announcements coming out.
Right.
You know, it just sort of seems like that sort of thing would exist. But I want to say Symphony of the Night was also released on the Saturn.
Maybe.
It's considered the inferior version, I believe.
But also probably extremely expensive.
Yeah. So I'm super excited because this will give me, regardless if it never hits Switch, I'll probably still add it to my PS4 library, especially because I've never played Rondo of Blood. I almost bought it on the Switch, but never, I mean, on the Wii and never did. So... these are games I'm super excited to put some time into.
I think I played Rondo Blood on the PSP.
Yeah, they had a remake.
Yeah, yeah.
Wikipedia shows that the Symphony of the Night only ever came out on PlayStation.
Really?
Yeah. I don't know. Do some research while we talk some more.
Yeah, you guys keep moving. All right.